This video is the second of two that go with section 57 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course, and the video covers the middle voice in the subjunctive, the optative, and three tenses of the infinitive. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn on pages 163 to 169 and in their appendix on page 743 to 745 for their coverage of the material. You form the present subjunctive middle exactly the way you form the present subjunctive passive. Yay! All things present, as you know, are from the first principle part. We put on the primary middle passive person markers, we give it recessive accent, and we know that it has progressive repeated aspect. Remember, you can't do a translation until you have a context when you've got the subjunctive. But don't forget that this time, if it is middle instead of passive, you'll need to give it a middle translation. The aorist subjunctive middle, alas, does not look like the aorist subjunctive passive, because we're going to go to the third principal part, where all aorist and middle forms come from. And then we'll have some endings. So here's our luo, and we'll need the unaugmented stem from the third principal part, because we won't be indicative anymore. And so we take off the alpha and we take off the epsilon. And we need a place to put our endings. And let's look at those middle passive person markers. And I'm going to need the primary ones, because the primary association of the subjunctive trumps the secondary association of the aorist. With lengthened subjunctive vowels, you get these endings, omai, a, atai, omatha, astha, ontai. I hope those look familiar, because they're the same as the present subjunctive middle passive endings. Yay! So, accent is recessive, and it's got simple aspect. No translation until you know what kind of clause it's in. Put together, the aorist subjunctive middle of luo needs that stem, unaugmented, and here we have the endings put on, and we're going to put in some recessive accent. I can't translate it, but I'm going to read it to you. Lusomai, luse, lusetai, luseomatha, lusestha, and lusontai. You can tell the difference between the present subjunctive middle, the present subjunctive passive, and the aorist subjunctive middle by looking at what stem you have. Let's move on to the optative and the present optative middle, which is exactly the same as the present optative passive. Principal part one as all things present, and ending with the omicron of the present tense and the iota of the optative, and so you get oimein, oia, oita, oimatha, oistha, ointa. The accent is recessive, and it's progressive repeated aspect. Of course, no default translation until we have a context. To form the aorist optative middle, we'll have to go to the third principal part, as we have to do for all aorist middle verbs, and we're going to add some endings. So, again, that will be elusa, and we need to get the unaugmented tense stem, and now for the endings. We're going to look at those middle passive person markers again, and this time we're optative, and so we're going to use the secondary ones. We're going to have the characteristic alpha of the aorist and the characteristic iota of the optative and add those secondary person markers. And this is what we're going to get. I main, I ah, ah, but here we are in that second singular, which ought to be I saw, but the intervocalic sigma drops out. And then we just close up the gap. There's no contraction here, and that's how we get the ia. And then to continue, ita, imetha, istha, and einta, which all follow nicely the regular rules. Accent is recessive, and it's simple aspect. No default translation, since you have to know your context first. So let's put those new endings on Luo. We'll need that unaugmented stem from the third principal part, and here it is. And let's put in those endings, those new endings. Imain, Aya, Aita, Imatha, Aistha, and Ainta, plus some recessive accent, and we get Lusaimain, Lusaya, Lusaita, Lusaimatha, Lusaistha, Lusainta. We still need to do infinitives. Present infinitive middle, aorist infinitive middle, and perfect infinitive middle. But happily, the present infinitive middle has the same form as the passive infinitive middle, and the same is true for the perfect infinitive middle with the perfect infinitive passive. Context will tell you the difference. So, as a reminder, the present infinitive middle comes, of course, from the first principal part. Our ending is esthai, accent is recessive, and the default translation now in the middle is to be causing to be verbed or to cause to be verbed. So you take your stem, and here we're going to do it from Luo, and you add the ending and the recessive accent, and you get luesthai, to be causing to be freed, or, because this is what Luo means in the middle, to be ransoming. The aorist infinitive middle comes from the third principal part, and that is just like all aorist middle verbs. The ending is asthai. Accent is recessive, and the default translation is to cause to be verbed. So if we put that on, if we do that with Luo, we'll need that third principal part, unaugmented tense stem. We'll add the ending and the recessive accent, and we get lusasthai, which means to cause to be freed or to ransom. Finally, the perfect infinitive middle, which comes from the fifth principal part, as does everything perfect and middle, and the ending is simply sthai. The accent is fixed on the penult, and the default translation for the middle is to have caused to be verbed. So if we make the perfect infinitive middle of Luo, we'll go to that fifth principal part. We'll take off the ending so we have the stem, lelu. We will add the ending, sthai, and we will put that accent on the second to last syllable. And we get lelusthai, which means to have caused to be freed, or, better with Luo, to have ransomed. And that concludes all the forms of the middle voice for the tenses and moods you know so far. You're ready to tackle drills and all the uses for the subjunctive, optative, and infinitives now in all the voices.